Sure, to be honest, it's just a nickname that's stuck. I love the breed. I think they're a loyal breed and, you know, strong dogs, and I think maybe it's developed from there. I've got a couple dogs myself, rescued a pit bull once. There was a dog that I took in, it was a pit bull as well, so I think it has something to do with that. My mum took me to a Thai boxing gym when I was like, I think she took me to a karate class when I was like 4 or 5, and I was that flexible, I weren't holding certain positions, and I got in trouble and cried and didn't like it, and I never went back. And then about a year later I went to a Thai boxing club, and from like 5, 6 year old, and just went from there really.
Like training be properly for about, how many years is it now? Probably 2.5, 3 years, almost 3 years now. But I've met him before, knew him from the kind of like the local scene, because he's, you know, Peter's is similar, like he started like in Muay Thai as a kid, and then progressed to doing wrestling and then jiu-jitsu. So it just all, even before like MMA was really big, it was falling into place that's the path he was going to go down. So he wasn't too happy with the training he was getting a few years ago, and he came over to me, and he'd just been working ever since really.
He loves doing it, and all the time, if you ever go and knock on his door, where's Pete? Oh, he's gone training. You know, things like that. He's really good at it and that, and he does it all the time, doesn't he?
Yeah. He lives and breathes it all the time. He really does. He's very, very dedicated.
Anyone who has a good work ethic, they're going to go far, and he's talented. He's good in a lot of areas. I think one of the main things about him is he has the right mind for it. Like, he can think about problems and think of solutions, and that is massive for this. Like, you need to be able to think real fast, like just do stuff on autopilot more than anything. Anyone who's like trying to always solve problems or try to do things differently or continuously trying to improve, you're going to get good at this. You're going to be suited to it, definitely.
So when he got to the age where he was 14, 15, and obviously he was taking his self-training, and he was off on his bike all the way to, I think it was Altrincham, and doing a session and coming all the way back, I knew then that the dedication, nothing was going to keep Pietro away from his training. And even, you know, when he was younger, that was my outlook. I was a single parent. A working single parent. There was times I would have been better off on benefit, but that wasn't a road I was willing to go down. You know, and when payday came around, the first important, most important thing was making sure that we had the money for Pietro's training, his transport, any private lessons, his kit. So it had always been very important, and when he got to the age where he took over himself, the dedication was very much there.
I've got the UCC British title. I won that at bantamweight, and then I won the vacant flyweight one, so I'm 2-weight division champion. I've also got the UCC European title, which I've defended. And they're the two titles, and then next week I'll fight for the FCC European title. Our gym is quite specific in that we have a lot of lightweight fighters, you know, from featherweight below to flyweight. We have maybe 20 guys in the gym that, you know, maybe 5 to 10 of them are pro, and the rest are amateurs, but they're ready to turn pro, and they cause a lot of pros trouble, you know. So the sparring we're getting is so realistic. We're always getting lighter guys in the gym, and, you know, everyone has different styles, and it's nice that everyone does have a different style, because if we come up against an opponent that's specific, like my next opponent likes to clinch a little bit, and, you know, we've got a guy in the gym who's really good in the clinch. So it's good that we've got guys in areas that are so well-rounded.
Yeah, in the ring, yeah, it's just, you know, in the ring it's just the fact that we've been over it so many times in the gym and, you know, drilled it. It's just second nature. There's a split second where he instinctively goes for something and I do. and whoever gets there first will usually get that specific position, or you know, it'll turn into a combination of positions or a combination of moves, or you know, I like to let the guy act a lot, and I'll react to what I always like to react. I don't like it when people react to my moves, so I'd rather react to their actions.
Granddad goes to every one of them, he does.
Yeah, I've been to every one of his fights, like you say, you know, and be there to support him and that, you know, and when he walks into that ring, it's a big thing, like, there's my grandson there, like, and you see this other fella walking in with his gloves on, think he's going to try and knock two puddings out of my grandson, like, but Pete, he's so good, like I say, once he gets in that ring and that, and you know, he loves doing it, so you just shout for him and back him and that, you know, and he comes out a winner.
I like watching MMA fights, preferably when my son's not in it. Obviously, I'm a mother, you know, you want to protect your kids, you certainly can't at that stage. I don't think I enjoy them. I like to see him doing, you know, some good martial arts. If I distract the fact that it's my son, yeah, I enjoy it.
At this moment in time, if you ask me which my favourite win was, it would probably be against a guy called Shamsul Haq, because he's a teammate of my next opponent. So it's just sweet that I beat him. It wasn't too much of a tough fight, to be honest. I controlled the fight quite well, and you know, I didn't really kick it out first or second gear, and I finished the fight. But just because it's quite sweet, because he'll be in the corner of my next opponent, and you know, they train together. One of my teammates just fought him again as well, and 4 weeks ago, me and Mark Platts was in the corner against each other. You know, I don't disrespect my opponent or anything like that, but for about 5 or 10 seconds, we was looking at each other, and I was just looking at him thinking, I want this more. I want this. So I could just see through him. I wanted it so much more. And we were kind of looking over, and I'm thinking, yeah, 4 weeks' time, we're going to have our shorts on, and we're going to be going at it. And it was a nice feeling, actually. I embraced it when I was in there. And he didn't look too happy, but his guy lost, so he wasn't going to. Pre-fight, when I'm warming up and stuff, I just go into my own world, put my music on, I go into my own world, I, you know, get warm, I just make sure I'm warm, that's the most important thing. And then I just relax a little bit. There's loads of things going through my head, it's like so surreal stuff, some stuff that comes into my head, like, one time, like, well, who's walked my dogs? And I'm walking out, I'm thinking, why am I thinking that now? Have I organised somebody to walk? I've locked my front door. I'm like, what are you doing? Come on, wait. Switch on, you're going out to fight it. Most of the time when I study the tunnel, I just get that exciting feeling / nervous, anxiety, fear, all into one. Everything's like rolled up into a big ball in my stomach, all these emotions. And then as soon as I walk out, there's nothing really there, to be honest, when I get in there. Yeah, so sometimes I think, when I stood at that tunnel, I'm thinking, what am I doing? Why do I do this? But then after the fight, I wouldn't change it for the world. I'd do this sport for free. You know, I used to do it as a hobby, and if I was stood at a tunnel and you said to me, right, you can go home now, you don't have to fight, there's no chance, no way whatsoever, I'd, you know, go through with it every single time. I love it.
Stupid man will say he's not nervous or he doesn't feel fear. I feel fear, but try and channel it and control it and use it to my advantage.
Really acknowledge anybody there. You know, it's quite selfish, but you're in your own world. I want this more.
From Liverpool, Pietro Pitbull Menga.
Pietro Pitbull Menga.
Can I ask you to the rules? And you must put yourself at all times. Mr. Man commands at all times. Any questions? If you want to touch gloves, do it now.
About to kick things here off against Mark Platts. Hold tight.
UFC referee Neil Hall starting this one off with the final instructions is Mark Platts. Oh, beautiful takedown, gets him here. Caught the leg kick to the body, swept the leg, put him on his back. And this really is Pietro Menga's domain. Already struggling here. Pietro Menga's currently on the wrong side, but he's looking to step over into mount.
Platts is aware of the danger he's in. Doesn't want to let him step through. He's already halfway there.
And there it is. He stepped over. It could be all over. Mark Platts steps out. And Pietro Menga with an incredible first round submission. Unbelievable. Pietro Menga is the real deal.
Unbelievable work there from Pitbull Menga. Very patient guys watching here on the amateur side of things. Need to watch that. Calm, collected, patient. Just took his time, wore his opponent out. And what a fantastic submission to end up. Absolutely fantastic night here at FCC5, here at the Bolton Stadium. Reebok Stadium in Bolton.
And we're getting covered in Pietro Menga's sweat right now, and I feel privileged.
That tastes good.
To have the body juice of Pietro Menga all over my face.
Brad, it's been an absolute privilege. Once again, we've had an absolute treat here.
Absolutely. Another fantastic night for Full Contact Contender. Our biggest main event yet. The entire show lived up to the hype as Pietro Menga embraces his coach, Jason Tam. Incredible performance from Pietro Menga. And what more can we say? A valiant losing effort from Mark Platts. Much respect to both fighters. Referee Neil Hall calling the fighters to the centre of the cage as we throw it to one final time to Jonathan Miller to make this one official.
So, ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes and 42 seconds of the first round, your winner by arm triangle, Pietro
wasn't much going through my mind after the fight. I was just obviously happy that I won, and I don't know, just enjoying the moment really. Jumping on a few of my coaches and, you know, giving them big hugs, and that's about it really. You know, it was just, there's a bit of relief to finish the fight, because, you know, you're in there, it's dangerous, it's a vulnerable place, it's a very vulnerable place to be in there, you know, and you can get, you know, sometimes you can get quite bad situations. So it's nice to, you know, come out healthy and safe, and my opponent come out healthy and safe as well. I've got a fight, planned for June. Just waiting on an opponent. I'll defend my belt. I'll defend my belt as many times as I've got opponents in front of me. You know what I mean? While there's an opponent in front of me, I'll defend my belt. Keep winning, keep improving, and keep growing as a fighter and as a martial artist. That's what I want to do. That's what my plans are. Travel and train at other places and get different perceptions on different sports, different arts, and then the UFC are coming back to Manchester on the 26th of October, so I cut my arm off to fight on that card. You know, they won't have to ask me twice to fight on that card, or fight any of them guys on there, whoever they want to put in front of me, an opportunity to fight there. You know, that's what dreams are made of, fighting in Manchester, my hometown. You know, it's a fighting city, we always produce top fighters, some of the best fighters in the world in boxing and MMA, and, you know, I want to be on that list of go down as one of the best fighters the city's produced. So fighting at the MEN in October on the UFC card, and that's what dreams are made of, but that'll be the beginning for me. You know, when I win there, it's just the start of me building, you know, I want to build a legacy, I've got big plans. Can't tell you the plans I've got, I can't explain them, they're in my head, I've got the plans, I'll be there, just need to let them go.